We're here with AccurateShooter.com for the unboxing, unveiling of the new NeoRest from Sebastian in Indonesia. SEB has manufactured a series of coaxial rests, and this is going to be the newest from SEB Lambang. Wow. So this thing is, as I understand, it's in a couple pieces right now and has to be assembled, but one of the key features on the NeoRest, as you can see right here, this central element, this section over here and this piece over here slide back and forth so you can adjust the width of your front bag. We're just doing a little walk around here so you can see all the goodies as they come out of the box. The base unit is a gray powder coated. There's a lot of shiny metal here. You see little white pieces, that's just leftover packing material. This is something new right here. These knobs are the way you adjust tension. That's a new feature that SEB added so that it's easier to adjust the tension of the joystick. The rest comes bolted together for compactness and shipping, but it's really pretty easy to pull the component pieces apart. My friend Joe has just used a little Allen wrench, and there goes one piece, and then another piece. One cool feature about this rest we just discovered is the front stop. It's actually hinged, so it folds up out of the way. Joe, show how that works. And then the stop adjusts. On this NeoRest, the actual legs for the unit are in two separate sections. To attach the front leg, first you raise the unit, and Joe will be doing that with the knobs that are on both sides. It's very smooth. To attach the front leg, the main piece goes into a slot right in the center of the unit, and there's a large bolt with an Allen head, and that Allen head actually goes into a recessed section in the front leg. We're about to install the rear piece. As you can see, there's a bolt that goes to the left side and a bolt that extends to the right side, and that will fit directly into the rear of the unit. And then you've got height adjusters on both sides. As you can see here, the bag itself has a left piece and a right piece. These slide in and out so that you can adjust the width of your forearm. As we noted, one of the really cool features and unique features about this NeoRest is the upper section of the rest where the rifle actually sits. You have a section on the left and a section on the right that are both milled out of metal, and they slide back and forth. This permits you to adjust the width of the front bag, as it were, for your forearm. It's really, though, not a single bag. There are three pieces. Here, Joe's going to show you how to slide it into place. That's a 3-inch wide block of wood that also comes with the NeoRest. Very nice. It has a bubble level in the middle. And there's a 3-inch wide forearm, and it looks like you can extend it obviously almost an inch or more in either direction. Joe will now show you how to remove the side plate and how to fill the side chamber. First you remove the large knob, then there's two small hex head bolts. They don't have to be removed all the way. just enough to reduce the side tension. Then you see the top piece actually opens up, and that's where you put the sand. The white tape is just serves as a gasket, as far as we can determine, to prevent friction on the side plate. There are two large knobs on the side that face the shooter. These are locking knobs so that when you adjust the height of the unit on the vertical shafts, you just use those big hand the big knobs, and that those will lock the gross height adjustment in place. On the other side, there's two small knobs. Those knobs are used to adjust tension on the joystick. Now you can set this front piece, or you can set this upper piece, either way, so that if you choose, you can have the tension adjustments facing the shooter, or you can have it set up as we do so that the big knobs face the shooter. We've generally found that once you adjust the tension, you're pretty much good to go, and that's why we have it set up so that the vertical height adjustment is accessible to the shooter. There's a built-in cutout on the rest that allows the shooter to pick it up very easily. We've weighed this unit, and on our bathroom scale it came in at 19.2 pounds, and that includes the joystick handle. It's pretty heavy, but easy to manipulate, easy to pick up off the bench. On other joystick rests, the handle is typically attached using some kind of set screw. The NeoRest has what we think is a better system. There's actually a collet that is held in place with a knurled knob. As you spin the knob back, the collet attaches and grabs onto the stub for the joystick. That creates a very secure and stable attachment. The other advantage, of course, is you don't need any tools to attach the joystick to the rest. All you do is rotate that knurled knob in and out, and it clamps right onto the joystick stub. That can be attached on either side of the rest. Finally, on the top of the rest, there are the side pads or side sand chambers, and you have little adjustments, one on the right side, one on the left side, and those can be used to push the vertical pads in towards the rifle so you can get some additional tension without changing the gap between the two sandbags. We found that actually works pretty well. There it is, the completed SEB NeoRest. Very impressive piece of engineering with many new features, as well as enhanced features. We've certainly, through our initial testing, found that it is smoother in operation than before and has a lot more vertical and horizontal travel.